one of the things that we're always trying to do when we manage forests is to be able to provide a range of habitat conditions. Some of the species that are most threatened that are often listed in terms of endangered status, potential endangered status, are species such as the California spotted owl and the fisher. How do you accommodate those kind of species, provide habitat for them, and also be able to have reduced fuel conditions and in some places more open forests, so when the fire does come through, it doesn't all just burn up into the overstory canopy. One of the positive outcomes of having this variable forest condition is that you would have places with higher tree density and higher canopy cover that could support habitat for some of these sensitive species, such as the owl and the fisher.
We have been looking at fisher response to forest management here for probably just over 10 years. One of the challenges in understanding the effects of tree mortality on fisher is that the mortality has happened really fast over the past 2 to 3 years. We still have fishers living in the same areas that they have for years, and so on the surface it might look like they're not responding to the tree mortality, but in effect it's likely that they're staying there out of habit. We need to understand not only what the historical conditions were, how we can actively move the forest in that direction, and at the same time understand what the effects are going to be on the various wildlife species we're concerned about. We have done a lot of research and have a lot of information on various wildlife habitat requirements. And so our challenge now is to integrate those two concepts. Where in a resilient forest can we conserve wildlife habitat? A fisher loves dense canopy, large trees, but it doesn't need that over 100% of the landscape.
I've been working with spotted owls conducting long-term research for the last 17 years. We've been monitoring California spotted owl populations up and down the Sierra Nevada to estimate population trends and track the status of the populations. Spotted owls use large tree, high canopy cover habitat for nesting and roosting. It's a particularly important habitat type for them. The challenge is providing that large tree, dense forest habitat within the context of restoring these forests to a more open condition. The research being done in the experimental forests is very fundamental to advancing our understanding of what the effects of these various restoration treatments might be on basic forest structure, but also the response of wildlife.